Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Lebrick. His Majesty Mohammed bin Isa Al Khalifa held a telephone call to get reassured about the health of the Emir of Kuwait, His Highness Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah. His Majesty the King prayed to Allah the Almighty to bless the Emir of Kuwait with abundant health and well-being to continue leading the march of progress and progress for his brotherly country and people. The Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa, met with the Secretary General of the Arab League, Ahmed Abu Al-Ghayth, on the sidelines of the 152nd session of the Arab League Council at the ministerial level to be held in Egypt. During the meeting, they reviewed the main topics on the agenda of the 152nd session. In addition to that, they also stressed the importance of continuing and intensifying the efforts aimed to enhance the joint Arab mechanisms for the benefit of the Arab countries and for the establishment of peace and security in the region. The Information Minister Ali bin Mohammed Ramahi said that Qatari media has become redundant in its campaign against Bahrain and has reached a state of despair in which it regurgitates false allegations and footage from over 8 years ago. The minister criticized the timing chosen by Qatari Al Jazeera channel to broadcast programs that provoke sectarian divide in month of Muharram, adding that such practices were not surprising from the Qatari channel. He said that the awareness of the people of Bahrain will continue to counter any Qatari attempts to destabilize the national unity of Bahrain. He noted that the Qatari media has been trying for 3 decades to target national unity and destabilize security in Bahrain, and that its attempts are doomed and will fail in light of the Bahraini people's awareness, unity, and rallying around their leadership. The minister added that the unprofessional media approach followed by Al Jazeera further proves that the channel is indeed a representation of the Qatari regime and not a private and independent media outlet as it claims. Al-Ramahi said that the Qatar regime preaches what it does not practice through its media rhetoric when it comes to discussing topics related to democracy, human rights, and sovereignty. He added that these were merely tools to attract attention after it had failed in gaining traction due to embedding extremism and hate speech through its various media channels. The minister said Qatar has repeatedly launched media offensives against Saudi Arabia, the United Arab Emirates, Egypt, Bahrain, and other Gulf Arab and Islamic countries over the last 3 decades. He pointed out that Qatar had embraced contradicting media messages in dealing with the consequences of its adverse policies, and that it uses reassuring narrative in addressing the local situation, claiming that Qatar was faring well and was not affected by its isolation resulting from its policies in the region. However, the Qatari media voiced victimhood in the international community, whereas its discourse aimed at the Islamic world continues in instigating extremism and hatred. The Shura Council stressed that the wise leadership guidance and the great attention given to religious rituals paved the way for the success of the Ashura season. Through its history and coexistence, national unity and community harmony, which has been strengthened in an atmosphere of freedom and openness experienced by Bahrain during the era of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, to the right of religious practices in accordance with regulations and laws. The Shura Council praised the continuous efforts made by the Interior Minister, Lieutenant General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, and all members of the ministry in providing a safe atmosphere to the Ashura season and ensuring a smooth flow and movement of religious rituals through the development of plans and involving in its implementation of various departments and sections of the ministry. The Shura Council noted the awareness of the community during the Ashura season, which contributed to its success and the civilized manner it was carried out, which confirms the importance of community partnership. In partnership with the Embassy of the Republic of the Philippines in Bahrain, the Filipino Creatives Group hold an art exhibition featuring 34 Filipino artists living in Bahrain and more than 80 artworks with the theme Ma Art at Oasis Mall in Jufair. More in this report with Hiba Abdelghafar.
Ma'ate, which means artistic and full of art in the Philippines, is the theme of an exhibition held by the Filipino Creatives Group, showcasing the rich and diverse talents of the Filipino expatriates who have called Bahrain their second home, in partnership with the Embassy of the Republic of the Philippines in the Kingdom of Bahrain.
Filipinos who come here, we have over 50,000. They've become very positive contributors and in Bahrain society as well as back in their families. They also found their place here, that they are part of this community and they want to give back to the community through their art, through the honest and good work that they do in their everyday life by being part of the society as a whole and expressing this and hopefully making Bahrain even more beautiful than the beautiful island that it is already.
The exhibition features 34 Filipino expatriates and artists in Bahrain, with more than 80 innovative artworks at the Oasis Mall in Jofair from the 10th to the 25th of the current month. The artists include painters, sculptors, and even photographers who come from different work backgrounds, but undoubtedly have genuine artistic talent and potential. Many of them were inspired by Bahrain's beauty and tried to convey how they feel about it with their art pieces.
Architect by profession, and what inspires me with my painting is I called it Bloom Where You Are Planted, because like what our theme, it is ma'arte, that means artistic, creative, and exquisite, and everything that is pleasing to the eye.
I have the Grand Mosque, which is very creative and spiritual like that. So it can show, it shows Bahrain that it is very creative. And also the iftar, which is taken from last, what do you call this one? Yeah, Ramadan. And it shows the humanity of Bahrain, that it cares in the people.
The group aims to promote depth and diversity of the Filipino arts in Bahrain, using innovation in arts as a tool of communication and friendship. Reporting for Bahrain International, Amhiba Abdullah Four.